back to another episode of Teen Scene. My name is Reverend McKee, and this is the second day that I was at Barbizon, and we got a lot to discuss, a lot of performances. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back, and we're going to take you to the Barbizon competition. There were a lot of dancers, ad-libbers, and it's amazing. Now, first up are the singers. Check them out. We're gonna go to break. We'll be right back. wow, wasn't that amazing? So much teen talent, and we got the dancers too. Oh man, did you see that? Man, they got some moves. I wish I could move like that a little bit, but. So now we're gonna talk about day two of the competition, and we're gonna look at the dancers.
And now we will start the dance competition. So without further ado, it's 2:40.
I don't know if you're trying to cut out the noise to get me the love in your voice, but I was so dead to all but myself. So you just went silent. Stop trying to help. It took a while to realize that things are clearer all the time. Those mistakes we made were mine.
Oh, no.
welcome back. And now we're going to talk about day two of the Barbizon competition. And now we're going to look at some improvisations.
Each and every moment, with an everlasting passion that only conviction will acquire. This means I will fight for what I deserve. I will not stop until my destiny has been achieved. Failure fuels my determination. Fear motivates my victory. If I only had one arrow, I will hit the bullseye. Because the only thing that will ever, ever stand between my defeat or victory is myself.
All right, thank you. That was 225. This is 226.
I dream about flying. I mean, not really flying, more like floating. It always starts with me running really, really fast, and then the terrain below me just becomes steep and rocky, but I don't stop. I just keep climbing higher with every stride that I take. But as soon as I look down, everything changes. I'm flying high up above the sky, right? Nothing can touch me. I'm free. I'm safe. But then it hits me. I'm completely, utterly alone. And then I wake up. I've never told anyone that before.
Up next, we've got contestant 232. 232.
Okay, enough about your breakup with your cat, which I'm pretty sure you may need some special help for that. Now let me tell you about my first date with Chad. I think he really, really likes me. After our date, I left him like 5 voicemails telling him how much fun I had, and he texted back, cool. He's so romantic. I didn't actually have fun though, because he took me to watch a scary movie. And I sat there the whole time with my eyes closed while he laughed at the screen. But at one part, he did get kind of scared, and he almost touched my hand! We're so getting married! Looks like my future husband's texting me now. I think we should see other people.
God, I can't believe you're such a heartbreaker. All right, up next we got 238.
Oh my God, Kenzie, you're not gonna believe my date on Saturday. Let me tell you this. So, as we got to the restaurant, I went to the bathroom to go freshen up. And as I'm freshening up, I look down and, there's a spider on me. I freaked out, tripped into the bathroom stall, my hair landed in the toilet, and so did my phone. I then looked down and my manicure is completely ruined. I looked in the mirror and I was horrified. Lipstick all over my face, and then I realized it wasn't even a spider, it was my eyelash. I could never let him see me like this, so I snuck out the back and let my friend take me home. Cats, do you think he'll call me?
That was 238, up next we got 242. 242.
What a lovely time to meet. I'll offer you a bit of advice. If I may, I suggest you to purchase a dog before you have kids, considering it is the patriotic thing to do. My husband and I bought a dog and named him Granddad, after my granddad, but Granddad had a terrible habit of running into the road and was hit by a car one day and died. So we bought another dog named him Granddad after the first dog, and this Granddad had a nasty compulsion of chasing after cars. He was also hit by a car one day and died. So we bought another dog and named him Mugger, but Mugger was just like the other two, and I was quite disappointed this having been our third dog that died and all. As I went to pick up Mugger's body from the street, a neighbor stopped me and said, "You know, you ought to keep your dogs on a leash, and perhaps they wouldn't run into the road and die quite so often." And I thought, that is an absolutely brilliant idea. So I turned to my husband and I said, "Husband, it is perfectly horrific picking up Mugger's body from the street. If we ever own children, we want
time
to keep them on
the leash."
Wasn't that great, man? Oh, so much talent. And now we're gonna go to break. We'll be right back. Wow, man, I want to talk to you about Babazai. when I went to Barbizon, it was, man, where do I begin? Man, well, when I first started going to Barbizon, I went for a competition, a model competition. So I had to go and audition and stuff and meet the judges and stuff that were there. And I was picked out of, I think they had, I can't remember the number, but it was a lot of people to continue the competition. And it was really, I was really excited about it because I was just, you know, trying to, you know, see how far I could go, you know. So the fact that I was able to go far and go down to Baltimore and compete even more in the competition was amazing. So I did that. I went down, I did some commercial that I did, and I did a model one, right? And after that, they started handing out awards for people for scholarships to school. So I was like, okay, that's cool, that should be some, you know, cool for some people to win that. So, and then they called my name. So I was like, when they called my name, I was just like, is there somebody else moving here? And so I was just like, me? So I was surprised. So I was like, I walked up and they gave it to me. I was like, I was so shocked. I was like, I wasn't coming here to get a scholarship to acting school in New York. But when they gave it to me, I was like, wow, man, that's really like amazing how like that it's something that I wasn't expecting to happen. So you can really surprise yourself with you know, if when you, you know, work hard and stay focused, that you'll be surprised at what you can accomplish. So when they did that, I was surprised, and that's how I was able to go to my school in New York and acting. So
all right, up next we got contestant 245.
Everything the light touches is our kingdom. But a king's timeless ruler rises and falls like the sun. One day, Simba, the sun will set on my time here and will rise with you as the new king. Everything that's beyond all words. You must never go there, Simba. Oh, but there's more to be king than getting in your way all the time. Everything you see exists together in a delicate balance. As king, you need to understand that balance and respect all the creatures, from the common ant to the baby antelope. Yes, Simba, but let me explain. When we die, our bodies become
times. Thank you. Next up, we have 1108.
Y'all, am I bleeding? Well, I will be. I'm having one of those days where I just keep running into things. Do you ever have those? I'm usually a very graceful woman, but something about this dress, it makes me feel like Bigfoot. I just ran right into a kitchen cabinet, like, boom! I'll probably need stitches before this reception is over. Terrified I'll do something wrong this wedding, and Scott will never forgive me. Just like the time I barked right in the middle of his Eagle Scout induction ceremony. Everyone thought I did it on purpose, but I think I just had a bad tuna salad sandwich that day. Anywho, oh, is this a bad time? I'm sorry. I'll leave. Sorry.
Please welcome 1109.
And if we're gonna be good friends, then I want to get to know you, the real you,
not the you you seem to put on. Do you get what I mean? I used to do the same thing. Until I realized that I care much more about being true myself than having someone like me more. There's more to like.
Bye.
Cap in the air, diploma in hand, looking out over the crowd. That moment, walking across the stage, when everything stops, it's almost like your life halts. 4 years goes by like that. I graduate. I did. And I don't know where to go from here. But that's all right. I'm not afraid. I know what I'm capable of. And this isn't an ending. It's just the beginning. Thank you.
Hustle up, ladies. Take a knee and take a listen. I'm not happy with what I saw on the football field today. Weak ass hitting is not tolerated on this football team. When you hit a man, you hit him. Drop him like a wet sack of crap and he knows he got dropped. Lower your shoulder and load, boom, boom! Defense! You don't just separate the man from the ball, you separate the man from his head. When I took this coaching job, they told me I couldn't coach the way I used to. They told me, but coach, it's only peewee football. They just want to have fun. I don't give a crap about that crap. You're going to be 8 years old, but you still got a pair, right? Are you here to drink juice boxes and have fun, or are you here to kill, destroy, and win? Nobody who ever played football became an actor, except that fellow on Webster. But I digress. Let's throw him up for Jesus.
Wow, wasn't that amazing? We had a lot to talk about. We had a lot to see. It was so amazing. I'm actually a producer of this show, so I'm learning a lot about the ropes too. There's a lot of talented teens out there, so you can learn to be in front of the camera or behind the camera. Which one it is, that's up to you, but you can do it. So thank you again. Thank you for having me, and I'll see you next time.